We welcome you. Thank you for taking this time to come and worship tonight. We don't want to be entertained. And I don't think the choir has come just to entertain. I don't think I know of any group that comes from one of our colleges that with that purpose in mind. We want to come and worship. Thank you for coming. Now let's open our hearts, shall we? Invite the Spirit of the Lord. Let's pray. Precious Lord, we do want to say thank you from the depths of our hearts for the way you come and minister to us and you meet our needs on a daily basis. Thank you for bringing us into this place tonight. Many friends and members have come. Lord, especially we want to say thank you for your presence. For you have already visited us. We want to raise our voices. We want to raise our hearts in praise to you. We thank you for Olivet Nazarene University. We thank you for those that are serving as professors, those individuals that are giving their lives, pouring their lives into young people's hearts and lives so that they can serve you. We pray that you would be with these young people as they minister to us tonight. And as they have already been blessed by being in different places and seeing different family members, members of the family of God, Lord, you have brought it to their attention that we're really one. Help us, O God, to know that when we stand and we use the best instrument that you have ever given us, the instrument of our voice, the instrument of our talents, Lord, we can give them back to you, and you can use, and you can bless others. We pray for these young people again. Touch them. Thank you for Dr. Dunbar, for his life, for the way that you have guided him across the years. Now, Lord, we enter into your presence. We thank you again for the way you've promised to bless. But Lord, you bless for a purpose so that we can be used in a greater way. We give you this service as we honor your word. Don't let your word return void. In thy name we pray. Amen.
Here back at Mattoon, I've been here on a couple of occasions to work with your choir and remember those times with great pleasure. It is our prayer this evening as we sing that the name of Christ will be uplifted here, that as you listen to these words, you will find meaning in them. We would like to begin with a set of two numbers. The first is Hallelujah, Amen, and we'll follow that with a spiritual called Let Me Fly. The soloist on that will be Scott Apple. Hallelujah, Amen, and then let me fly. In it. And in our program tonight, you will hear, I think, quite a bit of variety. We would like to do a piece now called Gloria. The words are very, very old, and the music is quite new. We would like to do the setting which is listed in your program, and I apologize, I think we ran out of programs, but let me just give you a word or two on this. This setting is by John Rutter, and we sing these words even at Christmas time in church. Glory in excelsis Deo, glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. For those of you who have a program, it's on the inside front cover. We're going to sing this in Latin, and we trust that you will enjoy it, even though the language may not be real familiar. Glory be to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill. We praise thee, we bless thee, we adore thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. Gloria by John Rutter.
Glory,
years ago when we were singing in Seymour, Indiana, First Church on a Sunday morning, I became aware over to my right of something that I had never seen before. There was a lady there who was signing for the hearing impaired. And since I had never seen this done before, I was, they're supposed to be moving now, right? Okay, that's all planned, so everything's all right. Did any of them leave? Okay, as long as they stay in here, we're okay. But as we continued in that morning service, I became aware of this lady over here who was doing some signing for some hearing impaired people. And never having been a part of that before, I tried to sneak a glance every once in a while as I could. And I began to be impressed with how beautiful and graceful this sign language was. In fact, I know she didn't know some of the songs that we were doing, but she seemed to be right in them with us because the communication was there and the enhancement was there through the use of this beautiful sign language that she was doing. Later, I discovered that there were some gospel artists around the country who were doing the same thing. Perhaps even somebody here does this in gospel singing. Sandy Patty, for one, I think in some of her concerts at least, will do one song with signing. So we would like to do a song now called Dear Lord and Father of Mankind. It's one of the songs in our hymn book. But we are going to add to that a new technique in choral music, a relatively new technique, called choralography. These are gestures and expressions which are meant to enhance the communication of the text. And so we would like to do this for you at this time, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind. prayer, we'd like to sing now three other prayers written especially for this choir by Ovid Young, who was on the faculty at Olivet Nazarene College when these pieces were composed. In the program, they're listed as three orisons. Another word for orison is simply prayer. These texts are taken from St. Augustine, Kierkegaard, and the Book of Psalms. Three orisons by Ovid Young.
be pleased with my song. For he has made me glad. I will sing and make music with all of my soul. He is my song.
And sing praises forever. I will rejoice and sing praises to God.
I will rejoice,
And sing praises forever. I will rejoice and sing praises to God.
I will rejoice
and sing praises forever.
I will rejoice and sing praises to God.
Turn to 437. We'd like to sing together a blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Would you stand with us, please?
Here we go.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of His Spirit, washing His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Thank you. Please be seated. Come, and he will introduce some students who are going to bring you word of testimony at this time.
Good evening. My name is Mark Howard, as you just heard from Dr. Dunbar. I'm the chaplain, so I'm going to introduce some people who are going to give a testimony. But before that, I'd like to give my own testimony. For those in the choir, you've already heard it, so you don't have to listen again if you don't want. But I'd like to share it with all of you. This is my last year at Olivet, and as many of you know who have gone to college or whatever, when you get to your last year, you start to look back on how things were and how you've matured and different things. And then you start to look forward to the future and wonder what you're going to do. And while it's fun being a senior and you like it and you can tell everybody, yeah, I'm a senior, I'm graduating, and that's all fun, but it's really scary because you don't know what's in store for you out there. And believe me, I'm scared. I hope to go to graduate school, but that's not up to me anymore. I've sent out all my applications, and all I can do now is wait. But as I expressed this morning, I want to express again tonight my faith that God has a plan for me somewhere out there in life. And I just want to thank Him for that. I know that He does because He's done it before. I didn't know where I was going when I came to Olivet 4 years ago or what I was going to major in or anything. And I took it one step at a time, and the Lord did show me. And so I'm trusting Him, even in the coming years, that He'll show me again. The first person that's going to come for us, I believe, is Tony McGuire. So she'll come up and give a word for us.
Six with you. God is our refuge and strength, and ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way, and the mountains fall into the sea. Though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her. She will not fear. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar. Kingdoms fall. He lifts His voice. The earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come and see the works of the Lord, the desolations He has brought on the earth. He makes war cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shield with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. So many times since I've been at Olivet, I've gotten frustrated. I guess you could say scared to death, because it comes to me more often all the time, what am I going to do with my life? And I don't know why I get these anxious feelings, because God has just blessed me incredibly, and He has taken care of me all my life, guided me in ways that I haven't been able to see. And I know He's in my future. It says so in His Word, and I just love Him with all my heart, and He's been teaching me this year that if I will just sit and be still and know that He is God, that He will give me a peace that passes all understanding, that He will be my refuge in my anxious times. And I just love Him with all my heart, and I praise Him that He is in the throne of my life today. Thank you. And now Cindy Oney is going to come share a word from her heart.
Careful then how you live, not as unwise but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. I'm a senior also, like Mark, and I would like to say that over the 4 years, the last bit of the verse, knowing To understand what the Lord's will is has been my goal. We've all been talking about a little bit of anxiety and being scared. But when you take the time to be still and to have patience and to not worry and to really seek what the Lord's will is, it just is a totally different lifestyle. And coming in as a freshman, I didn't understand that. I didn't really comprehend that. And now I'm thankful, number one, for the maturity over the 4 years to be able to get into the Word more often and to try and mature not only spiritually, but as we do get older and realizing that it's not going to be in college anymore. I'm going to be out on my own and not with my parents and all that kind of good stuff. And I'm really thankful for having gone to Olivet and thankful for being in Orpheus and to be able to sing those praises and rejoice. The song that we just sang, singing about the strength is in our song, and to use our talents and our abilities for the Lord.
And to share it with you all. Aren't you lucky? I've been, a lot of times I have problems finding time alone with God. And Dr. Dunbar sometimes says, before the concert, go and just find a couple minutes alone and think through the songs or just talk to God. And sometimes I just have to stop. And this song always comes to mind. It's a Larnell Harris song, and it's God speaking to us. And it says, I miss my time with you, those moments together. I need to be with you each day, and it hurts me when you say you're too busy. Busy trying to serve me. But how can you serve me when your spirit is empty? There's a longing in my heart, wanting more than just a part of you. It's true, I miss my time with you. And sometimes if I just stop, think of that song, and just spend a few moments with God, knowing that he does miss me, it makes everything so much better.
Has had a warm welcome to Mattoon First, can I put it that way? Last evening he called regarding the little shift in the schedule for the meal. And we, of course, were expecting our guest for today, Jerry Hick. And so it was exactly the time that we felt like Jerry was going to call and say, how do we get to the parsonage? And so I thought, surely, I'm going to guess and just take a stab at it and just answer Cook's Motel. Dr. Dunbar said, huh? And then tonight at the supper hour, the choir had gotten together, our own local choir, since Dr. Dunbar had been here and had conducted a couple of choir seminars for us. Well, the story, and I'm not going to take a long time with this, but the story was the last time he was here, he got picked up by a state trooper for speeding on the way here, okay, from Olivet. And so the choir got together and presented him, I think it's 2 or 3 years late, but paid that ticket for him, okay? Well, we just wanted to say thanks to the choir for doing that, although it's late. But the choir asked, how fast were you going? And, you know, he was kind of proud to say, my old car was going 64 miles an hour. He was kind of proud of that. But we do say thank you to Dr. Dunbar and the choir for being here tonight. He will probably refer to the record stand out and the display out in the foyer. If you would like to take one of the records and pay for it later, that's fine. If you would like to leave the money tonight, that's fine too. They are $5 a record. And that record, if you pick it up and look at it, it is a compilation of the great hymns of the church put together and sung and produced by the Orpheus Choir, Olivet Nazarene University. It is a record par excellence. I hope they don't run out tonight, but if they do, that's fine too. I want to show just a moment of the anxieties of the young people that you do make it after you graduate, okay? I wonder this myself. But I would like all the alumni of any of our Nazarene colleges, Olivet or all the other 11 of them around the United States. Would you stand, any alumni of the college? Sometimes take education for granted. We sometimes take our colleges and universities for granted. But, folks, they need to be placed right up at the top of our prayer list. They're made up of young people, and every time I see a group like this, I say, thank the Lord the devil doesn't have them all. Thank the Lord that we can give our money, our time, our efforts, our energy, and yes, our children to institutions like Olivet. And I came from a different institution of higher education. I came from Trevecca, and this is my fourth educational zone I've been on, which might not say too much about me, but I have not found any institution that is a better institution that ministers to the whole person than Olivet. I'm proud to be an alumni of a Nazarene institution, but a part of the Olivet zone. And tonight we want to dig down deep, I mean deep, folks, and pull out a good offering and give so that not only Orpheus but other groups can continue to minister as Orpheus has come tonight. We need a good offering. Let's give them one. Will our ushers come? The men who did put together the meal tonight, really appreciate that. And behind all of what we had tonight for supper, it does indicate a lot of time in just preparing that. And choir, we do want to say thank you. Shall we pray? Father, thank you for this day. Thank you that we can give from our hearts, give from our pocketbooks, and give from our very lives so that your kingdom can be built the way you see fit. Bless this offering, O God. Help us to give knowing that the kingdom is going to be built in just a little better way. In thy precious name we ask it. Amen.
My Lord, deliver Daniel and my.
Hark, I hear the harps eternal.
Hark, I hear the harps eternal. Hark, I hear the harps eternal ringing on the farther shore. As I near those swollen waters with their deep and solemn roar.
Eternal, bright and fair, when the saints of earth shall gather over on the other shore, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us tell of all his wondrous love and care. And when all our life is over and our world and earth is done, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
Some glad morning when this life is over,
I'll fly away
to that home on God's celestial shore.
I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
When we
all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
Before we sing our final number, The Majesty and Glory, I just want to say thank you to Pastor Cook and the congregation for the wonderful reception we've received since we've been here this afternoon. In fact, it's been more wonderful for me than for anyone else, because in this envelope is a $50 bill that was, I think, collected by Connie and the choir. And I really haven't gotten over the hurt yet of a woman state trooper giving me the ticket. That's what really hurt. I know that may take a few years to heal that little wound in there, see. But I honestly was speeding. In fact, it wasn't 64 miles an hour. It was 64.3 miles an hour. So just to be really honest with you, that's what happened. And I was actually, what I was doing was I had a piece of choral music on the steering wheel, and I was looking at it. And then the next time I looked up, I saw this lady with a hat on waving me over to the side of the road. And that's what happened. I hadn't had a speeding ticket since I was 19. And that's a while ago, see. So I've done pretty well, don't you think? Now we'd like to sing our final number, The Majesty and Glory of His Name.
Thank you.
choir is coming down into the congregation now to surround you for our time of benediction. We will continue to hum as Pastor Cook comes now and praise the benediction. Please remain seated, and then we will sing our choral benediction at the close of his prayer.
Tonight, and we say thank you. They have been touched through the power of the Holy Spirit, through your using these young people as your ministers tonight. We've been touched through the reading of your word, through the testimony of your servants. And just because you love us, we've been renewed in our own hearts and minds to make it another day. Lord, you have given us so many blessings. We cannot fathom them all, but Lord, they are real. Help us through the strength that we have received, through the spiritual food that we have feasted upon tonight, to keep our head high, our shoulders back, to know that there's not a single thing that Satan can do to thwart the spreading of your gospel. And Lord, we can go out with renewed vigor to know that we can face any obstacle with our hand in yours, knowing that you walk beside us, and we're two walk together this way, and yoked together in love, we can make it. Thank you for all of these individuals that are here, friends of choir members and parents of choir members, and individuals that have come to listen to your voice tonight. Lord, bless us all as we keep our faith and trust in you for the future, to do your will and know your will on a daily basis. For it's in thy precious name we pray.